Well, isn't this exciting? This is Alex Cooper reporting for Katrina and the Waves in the glamorous life of rock business in this very tour bus on the way to San Francisco. And here you have a beautiful example of how luxurious it is to tour with a genuine rock band. Now, here we have, for example, a rock star asleep. And here he is, a Mr. Kimberly Rue, British guitarist, genius songwriter with Katrina and the Waves. Mr. Rue, wakey wakey!
Good afternoon, viewers.
You'll notice that the rock star's Bible, Spinal Tap, this is a film about to be played so that everybody can remember each line from that, because that's a very important video. The air conditioning unit, which does not work. Only air conditioning units that do not work are allowed in rock stars.
Oh, I wish I was in the land of...
And here we have a genuine rock star.
Look away, look away, look away.
This is Katrina Leskinich of Katrina and the Waves.
I have found this tabletop here to be the most comfortable seat on the bus. So that is my permanent seat.
And here we have Vince De La Cruz, gaily dressed and quite smart looking as well. Very cool, eating a ball. You will see him chewing, and there's the ball he's eating in his hand. And of course, the most important decoration in the whole bus, the American flag. Here we are, Mr. Leskinich from Kansas, saluting the American flag, the most patriotic thing. And the most important person in the bus, of course, is the person who drives it. And we have a true star in the making, about to make his world debut on film. He is Mr. Ross.
Hey, it's you, Ross.
Ross, say hi to the camera there.
Hi.
He can't look at you, but he's a brilliant driver, a great commentator on life. I'm leaving.
Well, this group is really great to travel with. Some of the others aren't so hot. Sometimes you got a few problems. Well, there's a hard and fast rule, no groupies allowed on the bus. And that makes a lot of band members rather angry because, the humans are humans.
Hey, Ross, think we're gonna get a clear run from here?
I think so, Katrina. We're on flat land, and we're keeping good temperature. We're hitting about 75, so we can...
You know, it's real hot back here. Can we get some more AC?
The AC's on full blast, Arlen. It's about 190 degrees out there.
Yeah, tell me about it. All right, keep them rolling, Ross.
Oh, we're rolling,
Ross. Keep on chucking that, Ross. Let's keep going, okay.
We're rolling full blast. All she's got.
With this group, there's never any problems. There's no problems with drugs, no problems with heavy drinking, there's no problems with hostility, just no problems. A lot of the bands, from what I hear and from my experience, they get hyped pretty good on stage and then they can't come down again. They just stay hyper all the time, and that makes for a pretty rough tour. This group is just as calm. They step off stage and 15 minutes later, they're just back to being absolutely normal. I think it might have something to do with coming from England, where everybody is... sort of has that built in. There's no way to upset an Englishman, you know?
Steady there, Ross.
Bennett.
We just ran out of steam. I don't know what that means.
Sit over here. We're going to sit for a minute.
Rock and roll.
I'm
That Sunshine is the most upbeat, awesome tune to dance to.
It is a great song. It's a great dancing song. It's got energy.
I got their tape at home. I enjoy it. She wears bad shoes. She's got really cool shoes, and she's got good music.
Well, I got her tape. I think it's a great tape. All the songs are really, you know, each one's a little bit different, but they all have that original. I like the girl group sound, her voice. I like her voice a lot. It stands out.
I like Kimberly, too.
He seems like he has a sense of humor. He's clever. I like the music that he writes. Seems like he's a very intelligent guy.
I just like the way the music sounds. I mean, it's real upbeat.
An example of somebody singing one of our songs was the Bangles made a version of Go Down to Liverpool, and which was very nice. And then when we played in Hollywood, they all came and sang on Do You Love Me with us. You know, do you love me? Do you love me? And all that stuff. And that was nice. Made it sound a lot better than usual.
You'd think Mexico, she sings about Mexico a lot. Probably, it could be Liverpool, I don't know. Where do they come from?
Well, it all goes back to when I went to college in Cambridge University. And I went there to study archaeology many years ago, and Alex also went there at the same time to study cricket. He was a good cricket player.
And then we had a band together, Kimberly and I, called The Waves, back in the mid-70s. Kimberly then went off to join a famed cult band called The Soft Boys, famous for not having sold one record, but being very famous as a cult band.
Meanwhile, Vince and Katrina, their parents were with the American Air Force, and they were stationed in England near Cambridge. And they both went to church, and they met each other in the church choir.
And we realized soon after our friendship that we not only had similar musical tastes, but we also had a great desire, mutual desire for these items right here, which are very delicious,
preserved plums.
Preserved plums. And there happen to be two left in the bag. One for him and one for me. And you can see that these are hang fat hong, which everyone knows means wholesome and delicious.
Actually, the band's philosophy is encapsulated on the packet here. Philosophy is to hang fat.
Anyway, the years went by, as the years do, and eventually Alex met up with Vince and Katrina, and he introduced me to them, and that was the story.
Red Wine and Whiskey was written because we found ourselves in the island of Rhodes, which is part of Greece, and we played there for a week. We were supposed to be there 2 weeks, played there for a week, and then they found out we didn't have work permits. So the second week we spent on the beach, and Kim got inspired to write Red Wine and Whiskey because there we were on the beach with nothing to do and no money and just food and
it started,
beverages.
It started raining.
Good Lord.
We have achieved breakdown number two, if you're interested. Number two, breakdown. The bus has overheated and consequently has refused continue in a positive vector.
I'm afraid I threw the AC on a little too soon.
Ross has put the AC on.
The AC on, she just quit.
She quit. When Ross put the AC on, there is no more air generation.
So what we need is a minimum AC factor.
I'm afraid so, climbing the health, Katrina. I'm sorry about that.
Ross, you're fired. We'll be right back.
are you here?
Well, from Sacramento. It's only an hour away. We like Katrina. We like her music, and she really enjoys what she's doing. She's really happy, and it's well worth the wait.
Reminds me a lot of the 60s girl groups. She's like one of the lead girl group singers. She reminds me of Ronnie Spector, her voice sometimes.
When people compare my voice to Aretha Franklin, I'm just, you know, that's the nicest thing anyone could ever say to me, because it was the video, I don't know, of course you didn't call it video back then. It was a film of Aretha Franklin walking down the sidewalk singing Respect that really turned me on to music in the beginning. And I just, that was terrific. Really, my influences go right back to black soul music from the 50s and 60s, because that's when it was all in one take with a lot of sweat and, you know, really exciting. And I don't think that's happening so much anymore. Like, when we record, for example, we like to go in and plug straight in and get it all in one take. You know, I like to sing it all one time and not have to do it again.
And it certainly sounds like it. Writing songs about 3 years ago. In fact, I've written three songs, and two are on the album. One's called You Are Crying, and one's called Mexico.
Sometimes, on a couple of occasions, Vince would come over to my house and be acting really strange and quiet, and go and sit in the living room with the guitar on his lap, with a faraway look in his face, and, you know, I'd be walking around, turn down the television. Is there something you want to tell me? Is there something you want to say? Well, no. Well, what is it, Vince, really? Well, I wrote a song. That's great. Well, play it for me. Okay, well, no, I can't. I'll tell you what. You go into the kitchen, and I'll play it to you from there. So I went into the kitchen. That wasn't good enough. I had to go into the bathroom, and that wasn't good enough. And finally, he agreed to whisper it onto a cassette player while I was in the bathroom and not let me listen to it until he'd left. So it's a shy man here, folks.
Breaking down again. Look at how close we are to the top.
Let's get out and push it, Ross.
Breakdown number three.
Number three.
Yep. Any comments to make, Ross?
Ross?
None of them for camera.
Let me, why did your love grow?
about being on tour is you get hundreds of girls at the front of the stage, you know, looking. And the worst thing about being on tour is that they're all looking at Katrina and I'm being totally ignored.
No way. That's rubbish.
Alex, and you?
Well, I have a strong objection to communal living. And one has to do a fair amount of it on tour. I find that most distasteful.
Where was that where they were throwing little stuffed animals up on stage? Oh yeah, Magic Mountain, gig at Magic Mountain. It was great because they were throwing stuffed animals up on stage.
That was just the right group.
Yeah. Things like this. They were throwing them up on stage at us. It was that was very sweet. One of our best moments on stage.
I think the best bit of touring is when you get to the end of it. And probably the worst bit is when you start.
The nice thing about touring is playing live, because the audiences have been great. The other day we were in Del Mar, was it?
Yeah.
Del Mar in California, and 14,750 people turned up to see us.
And by the time we finished, there was a couple thousand left.
A couple of thousand left. It was great.
Are you going to see Katrina and the Waves?
Uh-uh.
Why not?
Because I don't like their music.
Yeah, how would you describe it?
Pop music.
You really don't like pop music?
Uh-uh.
What do you like?
Hardcore punk, MDC. Yeah.